Good evening, everyone. Time already for 4 p.m. I once again thank everyone to join the day two session. Today we are going to discuss about the Python, inside Python, the list and strings. The use of the list and strings, it is very essential when you're writing scripts in the Python. For example, if you have you might have received the email, which is automated. Like yesterday and today, those who were registered for this event, they might have received the email. So that email, if you would have seen that end of the email, I might have mentioned that this mail is sent by the Python program. Because it is impossible to do type or compose mail for all the 150 participants and sending individually. So using list and strings in Python, we can make it as a script and let the script send the mail individually. So today we are going to see what are the functions available in the list and strings. Now I hand over the session to Mahalakshmi.
I am correct answering. So good evening to everyone. Today we are going to see about the demo session on list and strings. First we are going to see about the list. In general, if you know C program, we used to tell the term array. It is just a collection of similar data items that we are representing here in Python as a list. So for example, I have given one list here, which is having 5 elements in the list. I have created one list under the name of number here. Using list, we can do so many operations. Once you create the list, how to access the elements in the list? It has been given here. So it will be starting from 0 index, and then it will be 1, it will be 2, it will be 3 and 4 like that. So to make you more clear, I have created the list in the name of numbers, and I have created inside the element also with the index only. So it will be more clear for you. Instead of giving some other element in the list, I have created the index number directly. So you can create a list with any of the elements like names or fruits or whatever you want, you can create it. But here I have given 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. So I will run and I will show you the output. I am just getting into the shell bpython. It will be easy for the user to understand. So I am using the bpython shell. You can go for the Python shell also. So this is our list. You can create any name for the list. I am creating the list with a num. List you have to create with the square brackets. So I am creating with square brackets and I am typing list with 1. I will start with 0 directly. So now I have created the list under the name of num, which is having four elements. Then how to access the elements in the list? Here I have given numbers of 0. This 0 will mention the index of the list. So here the 0th index of the element is 0 here. So you have to get the output of 0. If you access the index of 2, then you have to get the output of 2 string in the output. Similarly, 3, 4, like that. Here I am accessing our list, num of 2. Then I should get the output of 2 because 0 index is 0, first index is 1, second index is 2, third index is 3 in our list. So you can access the list using the index. So I am accessing number 1 index. So you will be getting the element of 1 here. In Python, you can access the list from the end of the list also by using the values of minus 1, minus 2 like that. So you have to give the index in negative numbers. So 3 is our final element, which is in the list of number. So if you want to access the final element, you can give num of minus 1. So you will be getting the output as 3 because this is the last element. If you want to access the last before element, then you have to give minus 2 in the index. So you'll be getting last before element like this. When you are there is two types in the array. One is single dimension, another one is multi-dimension. For this, here I have given example one list which is having two dimension. In the first, there are two lists in the list called number. These two are the sublist of the number list. So here 0 and 1 are the list 1 and 2, 3, 4 are the list 2 which is inside the list number. So when you are having the multiple list inside it, you can access like this. When you access number of 0, the total list you will be getting, first list will be accessed. So the index of this number of 0, if you give, you will be getting the list 1 as the output. And when you are giving number of 1, then the index of the second list you will be getting it. If you are having another list, then you have to access with number of 2. If you want to access the sublist element, then you have to give like matrix. So this is the list of 0th list. This is first list. So inside the 0th list, you have to access first element in the sense. Then you have to give number of 0 and 0. So you will be getting the first element. You will be accessing the first element. If you want to access the second element, then you have to give 0 of 1. So in the first list, you will be getting 0 of 1. I will be showing you, executing and showing in this shell, then you will be understanding it. So for example, I have created one list which is li, which is having two sublist. The first list is having three element in it, which is Maha, Devi and Arun, and the second list having two more names, Vian and Durya. So these two are a complete list which is inside the list called li. So I am creating the list now. So now I have created. Similarly, you have to access the list. If you want to access the list of li of 0, then you will be getting the first sublist totally. If you access list of 1, first index, then you will be getting the second list completely. If you want to access the first element from the sublist of first, then you have to access li of 0 and 0. So you'll be getting Maha. If you want to access the second one, then you have to give li of 0 first list. In the first list, if you want to access the second one, then you have to give the index of first. Because this is 0, this is 1, and this is 2. So for Devi, you have to access 1 and the first list, it will be having the index of 0. So 0, 1, you will be accessing Devi. In case if you want to access the second sub, if you want to access any of the element from the second sublist, you have to start with the index of 1 first. Then in this will be 0th index, this will be first index. If I want to access Durya, then I am giving 1. So 1, 1, you will be getting Durya. So similarly, you have to access the list. Same like that, vice versa, you can access from the bottom also, bottom of the list. If you want to access the last item from the list of this one, then you can access with a negative number. So you will be getting Durya. If you want to access the previous one, see here from the bottom of the list also, I have just printed and I have given the output with the comment symbol. You can see it. I have given list of minus 1. If I am accessing list of minus 1, according to this list li, this is the last list. This is the last before list. So if you give li of minus 1, you will be getting the second sublist completely. Then if you will be accessing li of minus 2, then from the last, this is the last before sublist, you will be getting the complete first list as your output. If you are accessing li of minus 1 and minus 1, then you will be accessing Durya as your output. If you are accessing minus 1 and minus 2, then you will be getting this as output. Then minus 2 and minus 2, then you will be getting the Arul as your output. Similarly, you can access the list from the bottom of the list also, and you can access the list from the top of the list also. Then you can use length of the list, you can give. If you give length of li, you will be getting the complete length of the list. If you give length of li, it is giving, this list is having only 2 elements according to this, because this is sublist, but according to li, it is having only 2 lists. So by using length function, you can find the number of elements available in the list. Next, we are going to see the sort function.
இதெல்லாம் கிளியர் பண்ணுறது ஓகே.
So next is sorting. We are going to see sort function. For that, I have taken one more list. I have created the list called prime, which is having some elements. So here I have given. So I have created the list, which is having prime. Fulla therida par. So I am going to use print panava. I have created the list with the prime. So this is the list. So with this list, we are going to perform some operation, which is called a sort operation. You can do these many operations with this. So I am going to use sort operation first. So I have done prime dot sort, which has been sorted. Now we are going to see the list. So this list has been sorted in the numerical ascending order. By using this function, whatever you have given in the list, it has been sorted. You can do the sort operation for the strings also. There it will be sorted in the alphabetical order. That also we will be seeing in the few upcoming videos. Okay. Here, one more function we are going to do. There is a function called reverse. So we have done prime dot reverse function. Now we can see the output. So you can see the reverse function. Once you use the reverse function, it will be just sorting it in the reverse order. So this sort function will be used to sort in the ascending order. This reverse function will be used to sort the elements in the ascending order. Then you can count. You can count the number which is present in the list. You can count how many times the number is present in the list by giving a number here. In this list, there is no repetition of number. So you will be, whatever number you are giving from the list, you will be getting the output as 1 only. I am giving here 19. So you'll be getting the output as 1 because the counting of this number in the list is only 1. If it is more, then you will be getting the counting as more. Next is, first I will be telling about the insert, then I will be going to index. So you can insert in the list. You can insert by giving the index also, and you can tell the object also. So in which index you want to insert a number. In case I want to insert the number between 37 and 31. So I have to check the index. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3. So I have to insert in the third index. Then I am giving the number 3. And whatever number you want to insert, you can insert it. So I am giving 23. So this number will be inserted in the index of 3. So I have inserted 23 in between 39 and 37. So you can check the count now for the number of 23. So the 23 number is repeated 2 times. So you'll be getting the count of 2 over here. Then you can find the index of any number here. If you want to find the index of the number, then you can find with prime dot index, and you can give the number. I am giving 11. So for 11, index is 10. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you'll be getting the index of this number using the index function. Then you can, next function I am using, primes pop. So if you use the function of pop, it will be deleting the final element from it. Now you see the list, one has been deleted. If this pop function will delete the final element. Again, I am giving. So two will be deleted. If you see the list, one and two will be deleted. Then we will be seeing remove. Remove function is there. Okay. So prime dot remove. So this remove function will remove particular element from the list. Just I want to see the list once again, then I will. So this remove function will remove particular element. You can give the number which element you want to remove. So this will be removing 37 from this. You can see the list, 37 will be deleted from this. Reverse function we have seen already. Okay. Prime dot extend. So if you want to extend the list, you can give the list of numbers which you want to add it. So this extend function will be used to increase the, extend the list. It will be used to extend the list. So I'm adding some three numbers to extend the list. Some error came, once again. Okay, I forget to give the function. So this is list which I have to use inside the function. So now I have added. Now you can see. So this three numbers has been added using the extend function. Next, you can generate a list by giving the index value. In case if you want to access the list in between the index from 10 to 11 or 10 to 13 like that, then you can mention it. So I'm giving the list index here from 4th index till 9th index I want to access. So I'm giving 4:10. So you'll be getting the elements from 4th index to the 9th index here. If I am adding some list like 1,000, 2,000. So it will be added with the list. But if you print the list, you will not get, you will not be getting these values because it will not save it if you directly adding some values with the list. If you want to really extend the list, you have to use the function of extend. If you want, you can create with some other name with for this list, and you can store it in that. Okay. Now we are going to create with strings. We are going to create the list with the strings. So I have created the list under the name of names, which is having four element with the strings only. There is no digits. So we are going to do some operations with the strings only. First, I am going to use sort operation, which we have seen last, same operation only. So you can see the result here, how it works for the strings. I am going to give sort operation. I am sorting this list. So it will be sorting the strings in the alphabetical order. Now you can do with the reverse. So it will be sorting it in the reverse order. If you have not done the sort operation, then it will be doing the reverse operation with this only. So directly it will do the reverse operation. Here I have done the sort operation, so you will be getting it in the reverse alphabetical order. Same operation you can do. You can use append operation. Append you can use, which means adding. I am going to use append and same WSF. So that has been added with the list. So you can see the list now. The initial list is with Suresh, Trini, Bala and Arul. Now I have added NCMRWF by using the append function. Same you can do. You can do pop operation. If you do pop operation, the final element in the list will be deleted by default. So this is your list. If you want to remove some particular name, then you can do remove and you can remove it. Python is case sensitive, so you should use properly according to your string. So now Suresh has been removed. So like this, the same operation you can do, whatever we have done with the digits. Then we can see there is a mixed list. It cannot be created, I think, with other languages. In Python, it is also possible. You can create it with a mixed list, which means you can create with a string as well as with digits also. Python will take both as strings only. Mixed list of knowledge demo. Illa. Okay, with this list, I am going to append some more elements. Names dot append. I am going to add 10 and I am going to add 10.20. Now you can see the list. So this list is mixed, like it is having string also and it is having some integer also and float also. You can perform operations also with this. You can add some number also. So we can see the index of this number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can add.
Names.
So names are 4 plus I'm adding some number with that. We will be getting 110 as a result. Then you can add with fifth index number also. You can add any number. So you will be getting the output for this also. You will not get the error in this. This is the advantage in the Python. You can create a mixed list, and with strings you can create you can make it uppercase or lowercase. Names of, if I want to change Suresh into uppercase, two dot, so these many operations you can do with the strings. So here I am using simple upper, so it will be converted to Suresh uppercase. I am using name of 1 dot we can use capitalize, so it will do the capitalize only. So you can see what are all there. You can make it title, it will be making like title. Then you can check whether it is is title, whether it is in the form of title or not. If it is is, then it will be telling true or false. Sorry, I just made mistake. Clear panna maldi per. So if it is in that case, then it will be returning true, or if it is not in the title case, then you will be getting false as the output. So you can check is digit, is lower. So you'll be getting false. So these many functions are there. You can explore it slowly, whatever functions is there. Almost I have explained all in the digits, and I am explaining with the strings also. We are going to the next topic. Append I have already explained. You can add with the numbers by using the append on the list. Now we are moving to the next topic, which is called a tuple. The main point in the tuple is it is immutable. So you cannot change the list. Once you have created, you cannot change the list. Last which we have seen is list. It can be modified at any time. But once you create the tuple, you cannot create it. It is immutable. You cannot mute it. So to create the tuple, curly braces is necessary. To create the list, square bracket is necessary. I have created the tuple with this parenthesis. So to create the tuple, this is necessary. This tuple cannot be changed. Once you create the tuple, it cannot be changed. So if I am adding or append, I am trying to do append operation to increase the number, it will be throwing error because append operation is not possible in the tuple. It is immutable. So there is no possibility in the tuple. You can change the tuple elements. So next is sets. Time now. 45. Okay. Next we are going to see sets. It is also deals with the list only. This is one of the list. I am creating another list. Okay. Now I am going to do the sets operation like union, intersection and all by using Python. Okay. For to create the sets, you have to use curly braces. So now we have created the list into set. We have converted this list into set. Same like that, we can convert the second list also. So now this also converted. Now we can do the operations of union and all. So I am performing the difference operation like sets. You would have studied in your school days like A minus B and all. So instead of that, I have created, instead of A, I have created names as the first set. Second one is names underscore one as the second set. So this is A minus B. Then you will be getting the values from the A. So you are getting the values as here, A minus. So you'll be getting the output of A minus B. So same like that, you are getting it here also. So you can do union operation also. There is a union operation. If you do union operation, then you will be getting both together. Set A means from the names set and from the names hyphen underscore one list, you will be getting the output both because we have done the union. If you do the intersection, you will not get any output because there is no common operation. So you'll be getting the empty set because the two sets don't have any common elements in it. Like this, you can perform all the operation which can be made with the sets also. So time is over today for the class. So we can go for the doubt session. I will be handling to Mr. Arulalan. He will be clearing your doubts as well as he will be telling some more few points. Regarding your strings.
We have seen strings so far. In strings, I would like to add two more points. In Python, we have single quote that everyone knows, and double quotes that also everyone knows. And surprisingly, we have triple quotes. It's something new, no? Triple single quotes, triple double quotes also there. So we are going to see the purpose of that. Like this is so this is a string. You can see that it just displaying it. Suppose if I want to display or use it, quotes, single quote should be printed while printing. See that you can see that a single code is being printed within that single. Suppose if I want to make it as a double quote to be printed, then I can do the single quote, I can keep it in the outside. So now the double quote is being printed inside the single, the word single. Suppose if I want to use both single quote as well as double quote, so how should I proceed? So we can use the triple quote. So triple one quote, triple single quote called triple quote. So I'm going to use both double quote and single. Then I'm ending with the triple quote. So it is showing, let me print it. If you are printing it, it will show. This is a double quote and this is single quote. And moreover, the advantage of the triple quote is, like, suppose if we have paragraph, we can use a triple double quote also. So this is so I'm entering multiple lines with a multiple space. So once it is done, so in whatever structure we have entered, the same structure will be retained. Like with the new lines, tab, space, it will be retained in the triple quotes, triple double quote or triple single quote. You can merge again, triple double quote, triple single quote, double quotes. So this will be very useful if you're handling very big paragraphs. And next, there is something called string formatting. Let me explain that. So with this, I'll conclude today's session. Suppose I'm keeping are you able to see it or not? Okay, then I'm keeping something called value. This is string. This is, suppose I want to place some number inside the string, so we can use this kind of value. So like whatever number being printed, like integer number, it's a common practice in all the language, D for digits or F for floating numbers. And this is a syntax which you can use it. Suppose if I want to use both value floating as well as next to next, then I can make it so what you have done within the string, we have replaced the particular space, like a percentage d being replaced with the first character, the first value, that's the integer, and the second percentage f being replaced with the floating. And there are multiple options in the floating point, like you can add, if you want to add like a zero padding, it can be done, like after element. Sorry, that works only. Okay, I will explain that. Then, so this is a general practice. You can use a string also. Like we can add a string. For that we have to use percentage s. So I'm just using my name. And other than that, so another practice, this will be in the Python 3 or like we can keep it just curly braces. We don't need to specify anything. Close, then format. There you can keep the values as it is, whatever you want. See that we don't know what value being kept here. So what are the arguments kept here? That value being replaced here. And then here we kept it the argument. And what are the value? Oh, this is the float, and float is being kept here. And finally, this is being replaced with this argument, Suresh. So this is the string. So this is end of day two. Not day one, I didn't modify it. And let me go to the doubting sessions. I have come to doubt sessions. So please ask questions here if you have any doubt. And I'll just start with yesterday's 20th question. Somebody asked yesterday how to install bpython in Windows. Here I listed out the procedure. You can go to these links and you can install bpython in Windows also. Otherwise, if you install Anaconda or Conda in Windows and using pip or easy install, you can install the bpython in Windows as well. And let me go to today's question. Yes, the second question is that a prime dot in some value dot index 13. And if 13 is repeated, what will be the output? So it will print the first occurrence. The index will always go for the first occurrence. And third question is that a test is equal to names.sort. Will the output of the names.sort saved to? Yes. No, this will not work. This will not work. Why? Because the names.sort is not returning anything. It's just changing the names object. As it's a list, it's a list is immutable. So it's just changing and then saving it to the same object itself. So for this, just a names.sort would be sufficient. And it will be, the result will be saved. Only this is sufficient because it if you are saving it, the test will be just a none. It is not returning anything. And the fifth one is that what is the difference in using single? That's I just mentioned. Right now there is no difference much in the single and double, but if you want to use both together, then it will be useful. So what is the use of parentheses in upper? You mean to say that upper function, which we called. So this is something called object. So everything is in Python, everything is object. So in our object, we have methods or functions that has to be called by calling the parentheses. So we have seen many functions, sort, reverse, everything being called with a parentheses. I'll just go with the 8th one. What is the use of tuples? Tuples generally we will use, suppose, while you're writing program, you may be decided few of the elements or few of the lists should not be modified within a program itself. Say, for example, if you're talking in terms of a scientific one, say list of latitudes. So the values in the latitude, we have different set of values in the latitude and longitude. Once we defined it, we should not change it within our program by mistake. So in these cases, we can go with the tuples instead of list. So even by ourselves, we'll not be modified the once we define the values. And sixth one, please explain the difference between list and tuple. In terms of computation time, I don't think you can find much difference in terms of computation time. Yes, we will share it. If you want to share today itself, then we can upload and we'll share it. Today we will share yesterday's and today's, and we will keep it in the YouTube description box, as well as we will send in the mail. And somebody asked, can we append multiple strings? Yes. Yes, you can go with the extend. If you want to append multiple elements at the same time, then you can go with the extend command instead of append. Suppose I'll just go. This is a string. So you want to extend it. Again, I'm adding multiple elements as a list, which will be added. Extended, we are extending the list in a single command. Append will just allow us to add only one element at the end of the list. Okay, right now 5 p.m. I hope everyone enjoyed it. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask questions at this URL. This URL will be there anytime. You can come and ask the questions, and we will be responding. If you are not able to respond it, this will be saved while you're typing. This is being already saved, like names.sort. You can give it a try at your own. This is name, this name. Let me do sort. Yes, this name is being sorted now. Like the first is 1, then 2, then 3, then again 2. This is because this H is the common character. Then it go for the second character. Second character H is the first occurrence. Then W will comes. So by this way, it is being sorted and then stored within the variable itself. Okay, if you want without sorting, I mean without changing it, you can make a copy of it and then you can do sort. So it will not affect the original one. This is the output. It's not working. Okay, let me know if you have any questions and ask it here. If it is not resolved, again ask it here. We will answer all the questions. Sample codes also we will putting. We will share whatever the codes we shown, and that also will be shared in the GitHub. And the links, all the links will be posted in the YouTube description, as well as we will send the mail. I once again thank everyone.
Thank you to everyone for attending my classes. We will meet you tomorrow.
So tomorrow again, we will be discussing about dictionary and loops. And partial strings and loops.